Hi, this is Brian with Prophetless Medium Post, and today we're going to do a quick tip tutorial on how to add 2D tech to a 3D camera tracked scene in DaVinci Resolve Fusion. I just recently had a comment on one of my other videos and thought I would do a quick video on how you can do that. If you'd like to follow along, I'll put a link below where you can download this clip. So the first thing we need to do is do our camera track. So let's add in a camera tracker. And over in the camera tracker, the only thing we want to turn on is bidirectional tracking, and then we can hit auto track. Okay, great. When that's done, we can go over to the solve and hit solve. We have an error over one, so I want to definitely refine this. So I'm going to hit select tracks and then delete. That'll get rid of the bad tracks, and then solve to refine again. Okay, great. That's a decent error. So now let's get over to export. And before we export, we want to set up our ground plane. So let's open up 3D scene transform, click on unaline so we can select the points. And I'm going to grab this point right here in the center and set the origin. And then I'm going to select a whole bunch of trackers on the ground. Holding shift, I can add to that selection. And we'll use that for the ground plane. Once we have that, we're going to click on aligned so that we'll use this information. And then we can hit export. All right, I'm just going to clean this up a little bit. We don't need the ground plane, so I'm going to delete that. And we won't need the camera tracker anymore, so I'll delete that. And let's take a look at what we have. Okay, let's make this a little bit easier to see. Inside the point cloud, go over to our controls under style. Let's hit point. And then let's bring down the scale a little bit. Okay, that's good. So now you can see we have a decent point cloud. You can clearly see we have a decent representation of our 3D world, of our boardwalk. So we are ready to put in our 2D text. Okay, so let's add in our 2D text. Let's put that up. The way that we're going to do this is we're going to use the image plane to put our text on, and then we can put it into 3D space and render it out. So now we have our text, and we want to scale this up to fit the whole entire image, because the way it works is the resolution of this image is what's going to go on the image plane. So if we leave the text that small, it's going to be pretty low resolution. So let's scale this up and just scale it up so that it fills almost the entire frame. Okay. And now that we've done that, let's add our image plane. And then we're going to take our image plane and connect it right to our 3D merge. Now we can look through. Okay, so in the image plane, we're just going to scale this down. And we want to scale this down so that it kind of fits in the width between the two railings. So it's probably going to be something like, something around there. That looks pretty good. It's about the right size for this scene. Okay, and now we're ready to place the 2D text wherever we want. So the way I like to do this typically is to, inside the 3D viewer, let's right click, go to camera, and let's look through the camera. So select camera 3D1, and now we can go through and we can see all the points lined up on the actual original image. And we'll be able to pick the point where we want to bring our text. So I think I want to have the text somewhere right here in the middle. And then we'll have the camera fly right through in between the two words. So kind of go right in the middle. So I'm going to use maybe this point right here. So if you just click and drag, you can select a point, right click on that point. Go down to point cloud 3D and copy point position. Once I do that, I can go to the image plane and under transform, go to translation, right click, paste translation group, and that will push the card right to that point, centered on that point. So when we push it to that point, that means half of the card is actually below the boardwalk, and we can visualize that by splitting the view. And let's take the merge 3D and throw it in this view also. And this one is in the perspective view. And if we come to the side, you can see the card is underneath. So way we can do that, we can just bring this back up. So we're going to bring it up above the boardwalk. We want the camera to go right through that center. So what we can do is, you can see this green snake-like here. That is the path, the camera path. If we zoom out, you can see the camera path is right there as I go through. So we can just position this so it's kind of centered on that path. So I'm going to bring this up. Yeah, something like that's okay. And so now we can see in the 3D view. Let's see how it looks. Yeah, that's basic. So that's how you can add your 2D text with your 3D camera solves. Okay, now this is one way. So if you have any problems, reach out in the comments. I try hard to answer everybody's questions. But anyway, let's just finish this off while we're doing this. If I were going to finish this off, I want to get the text by itself. So one way you can do that is take the background off the camera. And now if we look through the camera renderer, we have just the text. And I'm going to make this a single viewer now. In the renderer, I would switch it to software renderer, makes it a little bit softer. And in the settings, because there's the 3D tracking, I'm going to add some motion blur. Set that quality up, maybe like 6. And then we're going to take our render, and we're just going to merge it back over the top of our original clip. We look through that, and then here we go. And it should have nice motion blur now. You can see there's a little bit of motion blur on it, and it looks pretty good. So anyway, I'm going to render this out. So that's one way to add 2D text to a 3D camera solve inside DaVinci Resolve Fusion. If you have any questions, feel free to reach out in the comments, and I'll try to answer your questions as best I can. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you again in the next video.